Hi everyone, this is Shweta and welcome to Coffee Curves. Today I'm going to share with you all this beautiful traditional Indian backdrop that is perfect for a housewarming ceremony, for a traditional Indian baby shower, or even for bridal celebrations such as haldi, mehndi or engagement ceremony. Before we start with the video, I request you all to subscribe to our channel Coffee Curves and hit that like button to show your support. Now let's start with the video. To start with, I will first show you how to make these crescent or moon-shaped decorative pieces. For this, I'm going to be using a cereal box. You can use any lightweight cardboard as well. I just wanted to keep it as light as possible. Using any circular object, I'm going to trace out a half moon shape. To get a nice shape, take about 2 inches more on the sides and then draw the other curve. Now join both the curves together as shown and cut it out with a pair of scissors. Next, I'm using acrylic colors to paint these. You can use any paint that is available on hand, as these are not really going to be seen much because I will be covering these with something else, which you will see in just a short while. So I made 2 of each color. Now let's move on to the next step. Using gold foil cardstock paper, I cut out some circles. After painting, you might notice a little bit of bend in these, so I'm just straightening it out a little bit. Now start sticking the golden circles with glue as shown. To speed up this process, apply glue to these golden circles all at once and then stick them to the base all together. Now I will stick another layer of these circles as shown. And once these are ready, let's move on to the next step. Now we are going to make some paper beads out of gift tissue paper. I've chosen these colors for the outer beads and white gift tissue paper for the inner beads. Fold multiple sheets at once and cut them into squares. Repeat the same steps for the colored paper. And once these are all cut and ready, we are going to start making our paper beads simply by just crumbling the paper. Just make sure to not apply too much pressure and don't fully crumple them. Now this process is actually very easy and a lot of fun. You can even do it while watching TV and even have your kids help you making these paper beads. I'm sure they're going to have a lot of fun making these, just like my daughter did. And by having your kids involved and help out and be a part of the celebration that's going on at your house gives them a sense of pride and brings the whole family together. Now the inside beads are ready. So I was a bit short on the white gift tissues, so I did use a light pink color for some of them. And now I will use the outer colored gift tissue paper to cover the inside white beads. You can use the same color tissue paper for the inside and the outer bead as well, but I found the white tissue papers a bit cheaper, so that is why I used white for the inside and the colored one just for the outside. You will need around 100 beads for this size. Next, I will start sticking the paper beads to the base. First, apply glue and secure the loose ends, and then glue them to the base as shown. First, glue the beads to the outline and then fill up the center. And this is what it is going to look like. Now to hang these, this is what I'm going to do. First, I will stick a small piece of cardboard on both the ends. And to hang, I'm going to stick this crystal bead string that I got from Amazon. The link will be in the description box. Using glue gun, stick one side. Count the number of beads before sticking so that you can maintain the same length for all the six pieces. This crystal bead string comes in a roll, but I had them pre-cut for another project, so I'm just sticking the extra part at the back. To hang these, I'm using a thick rhinestone ribbon. And attach it with the help of a safety pin. Now next I will move on to the toran making. I have already shared a detailed video on how to make this toran. I will link it in the description box. You guys can check it out if you're interested. But right now in this video, I will be just sharing a new trick that I figured out with which you can make the toran longer as per your requirement and even attach small pieces of toran around the big one with just this simple trick. Before making your toran, pass a bead and tie 2-3 knots as shown. For a stronger toran, fold the starting bit and then start stitching. And once you reach the desired length, pass a bead again and pass the needle a couple of layers down and pull it back up. Go around the bead a couple of times. Now fold the thread into a loop and then pass the needle through the bead as shown and then finally knot it 2-3 times. Now this becomes something similar to a button and a hole. And you can easily put them together and get them off as required. I did the same trick with the longer torans as well. You can easily hang these anywhere with a thread loop or use a safety pin to hang these to the backdrop. You can even connect them with a safety pin and make them into a longer garland. To this, you can easily attach the smaller garlands. And you can also attach these small garlands to the toran ends as shown. Now all the decorative pieces and the torans are ready. Let's start with the final assembly. So here I have already fixed my yellow satin fabric to the backdrop stand. I have simply fixed it with a safety pin on the back. I have also tied a jute string on top to which I will be hanging the six decor pieces. And since these pieces are a bit heavier, it was pulling the string to the front. So I hung two bags with some weight inside it to counter the front weight. I will start by putting this beautiful DIY Ganesha that I made with the help of a thread and safety pin, and I will attach it to the same string that I showed you earlier. If you're interested in knowing how I made this DIY Ganesha, do let me know in the comment section. I will try to make a video on that soon. Next, I will hang these decor pieces. And to this, I have already attached a small pink toran that I showed you earlier. Again, using a safety pin, attach these to the string at the back. Just by adding a string on the top, it becomes really easy to attach and remove any decor pieces from the backdrop. And at the same time, you won't have to attach a lot of safety pins onto the fabric, and hence the fabric stays in a good condition for a long time. Another advantage of hanging these onto the string is that you can easily move and adjust them as required. Next, I will hang these DIY torans that I made. I am also going to add this DIY paper mango leaf toran to add that extra traditional touch. This mango leaf toran is a really easy DIY to make and it looks like real mango leaves. And since we don't really find mango leaves here in the US, this one is a really helpful DIY that you guys can try at home and make your own mango leaf toran. Add additional pins in the center if needed. I also made these DIY decorative pedestals. These are super easy to make and add a beautiful touch to your decorations. I will share a detailed tutorial on this in my next video, so stay tuned for that. Now let's go see how the final decoration looks. I hope you all found this video useful. If you like this video, please hit the like button and let me know in the comment section. Share this video with your family and friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel Coffee Curves and follow us on Instagram and Facebook for latest updates. Inspired from this video, if you do try this decoration, please do share your pictures with me on Instagram, Facebook or through email. See you all soon in my next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.